Welcome to Kishore's NEET Parashala. In this video, we will see the second topic on gravitation chapter, that is the universal law of gravitation. Universal law of gravitation, it is a very important and everyone knows it. Suppose if there is a block of mass m1, another block of mass m2 separated by a distance r, then force acting on the block is directly proportional to product of the masses and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. So you can see that force is inversely proportional to r square. So as the distance increases, force decreases because they are inversely proportional. Okay, and g is the gravitational constant whose values is 6.6996 into 10 power minus 11 and m square kg power minus 2. They will ask the dimensions of universal law of gravitation, and the dimensions also you must know. And what is the applications of this law? Let us see on the exam point of view. We have seen that F is inversely proportional to R square. So I am writing it like this. F is inversely proportional to R power minus 2. So now if I fractionate it, delta F by F, that is change in the force, is equal to minus 2 into delta R by R. What is the minus sign indicates that? If the distance increases, the force decreases. The decreasing is indicated by the negative sign. Okay. And acceleration due to gravity is indicated by the letter G. This everyone know. So G is equal to Gm by R square. This is a common type of formula that you learned right from your 10th standard. Suppose instead of radius, in the question they are asking you to use diameter. Then instead of r, you must substitute radius is equal to diameter by 2. This is the previous year question 2. Instead of r, you must substitute radius is equal to d by 2. Okay, this is the previous year question application. Now let us see certain extra edges. Okay, force is equal to gm1 m2 by r square is the universal law of gravitation. In certain cases, you must have the condition to apply force is equal to m omega square r that is equal to mv square by r, omega is equal to 2 pi by t, and t you can apply as 2 pi r by v according to the condition given in the question you want to use. And another one previous year question application is, remember this equation gmk is equal to 4 pi square. What is the equation? Gmk is equal to 4 pi square, where k is nothing but, in the Kepler's third law we have seen that t square is proportional to r cube. To remove the proportionality, I am introducing a constant k. T square is equal to k square r cube, where the k is this k. Gmk is equal to 4 pi square. This is also a previous year question application. Gmk is equal to 4 pi square. This you want to remember. And this is a question, let us see. If distance between sun and earth is increased by 2%, find the percentage change in the gravitational force. So what is the gravitational force? F is equal to gm1 m2 divided by r square. So F is proportional to r power minus 2. So delta F by F is equal to minus 2 into delta r by r. Here they have given the distance between sun and earth is increased by 2%, that is delta r by r is equal to 2%. Since it is increased, I am using it a plus sign. So delta f by f is equal to minus delta r by r is 2%, so 2%. Okay, so which comes out to be minus 2%. So as the distance increases by 2 into 2%, so 4%. So as the distance increases by 2%, the gravitational force decreases, that is indicated by negative sign, by 4%. Now let us see this numerical. Two bodies A and B having mass m and 3m are at a distance y. A small particle of mass m is to be placed so that net gravitational force on it is zero. What will be the distance from body A, they are asking. Okay, the mass A whose mass is m and another B whose mass is 3m. Okay, it is separated by a distance y. Here you are placing one mass m m you are placing, which is at a what? Okay, it is experiencing a zero gravitational force. What is its distance from y? They are asking. Okay, so when the gravitational force experienced by this mass is zero, when gravitational force of A on M is equal to gravitational force of B on M, then only the force acting on the small mass M is zero. So gravitational force on A on M is given by G into mass of A into small mass M divided by x square, that is equal to gravitational force of B on M. So G into mass of B is 3m into small mass M divided by this distance is y minus x. So y minus x the whole square. So G get cancelled, M and M get cancelled. So this m and this m also get cancelled. So 1 by x square is equal to 3 by y minus x the whole square. So if I take root, which is 1 by x is equal to root 3 of y minus x. So y minus x is equal to root 3x. Y is equal to root 3 1 plus x. Y is equal to x of 1 plus root 3. So x is equal to y divided by 1 plus root 3. This is the distance x between mass of A and another small mass m. So if it is placed at this distance from A, then the gravitational force experienced by the small mass m will be zero. Okay, this is a common type of question you must remember. I hope you like this lecture. If you like this lecture, please subscribe Kishore's Neat Paathashala. Thank you.